Allergies are an overreaction of the immune system to harmless substances known as allergens. Examples of allergens are pollen, dust, eggs, peanuts. In fact, peanuts happen to be one of the most common food allergies in the United States. While some people can consume peanuts and experience no allergic response whatsoever, others experience an allergic response that ranges from mild to severe. A severe and serious allergic response is known as anaphylaxis. So what does this mean for vaccines? Vaccines, just like any other drug, have the potential to trigger an allergic response, but it's very rare. An allergic response to a common vaccine is so rare that it occurs in only about 1 in 500,000 doses to about 1 in a million doses. And anaphylaxis, or a serious allergic response to a vaccine, only occurs in about 1 in 1.5 million doses. Now, the type of allergic response that you might experience after getting vaccinated is very similar to the type of allergic response experienced by those suffering from peanut allergies. When you're exposed to an allergen, your body begins to make certain types of antibodies, known as IgE. Now, antibodies are very important in providing protective immunity, but antibodies like ice cream come in many different flavors, and IgE is one flavor that can trigger an allergic response. When these IgE antibodies are made, they begin to bind and lock on to certain types of immune cells. So when you're exposed to the allergen on a second round, these allergen particles can bind to the antibody themselves, causing the immune cell to then release inflammatory chemicals like histamines. And it's these inflammatory chemicals that then go on to lead to the hallmark symptoms associated with an allergic response, like a runny nose or shortness of breath. But these allergic reactions are very easy to manage using epinephrine or an EpiPen. And all medical facilities that administer the COVID vaccine are required to have epinephrine on site. Now, while in very rare cases, an allergic response can occur after getting vaccinated, vaccines on a whole are safe and extremely effective at preventing infectious diseases like COVID. Moreover, if you know you have a food allergy or you've been allergic to certain types of vaccines that contain food proteins like an egg protein, rest assured that both approved RNA vaccines on the market as of now contain no food-based proteins. And in our next video, we're going to be talking to you about the general components that make up a vaccine, and Rob is going to go into the exact ingredients in the Moderna and Pfizer vaccine specifically.